again this morning with Power Metals' Paul Johnson. Paul, good morning. Good to have you back.
Good morning, Andrew.
Been a big year for you, Paul. Look, assuming people watching this might not be too familiar with Power Metal, give us a recap on the company.
Yeah, sure. Well, as a CEO, you automatically assume everyone has the same degree of knowledge and understanding as you do of the business, and that's not the case. We've been building furiously in Power Metal over the last couple of years, and we're now a global operation, which sounds very grand. We do have operations in North America, in Canada, and in Arizona, USA. We have operations in Africa, mainly base metal across a number of countries. And we have our Australia Gold joint venture in the Victoria Goldfields. So we're spread across commodities, we're spread across jurisdictions, geological risk, and all the different areas that you can imagine to try and give our shareholders broad exposure to lots of different things. We're looking for a major metal discovery, or my personal preference, discoveries, that can transform the lives of shareholders. It's as simple as that. If you're a shareholder, you pay my salary. It's not that great, I can tell you, but I'm here to make you money.
And 2020, Paul, a year like no other. How's it been for you? Have you been able to advance some of these projects?
Yeah, it's been an incredible roller coaster. I think there's good from a resource sector perspective, of course, because we saw the COVID dip back in March and we came out of that with the rest of the stock market, really. But the natural resource sector has seen a boom in conditions over the last few months, with metal prices high, junior company prices high, major company prices high. So we've done well in our space. Power Metal itself as a business has made its kind of business portfolio on the back of difficult market conditions. We've acquired interests when very few people were interested. It's something in my personal career as a PLC director I've focused on, is looking for the opportunities when everyone's running out the door, as it were. And we've been able to assemble a portfolio of 9 projects during the last 2 years, but particularly we brought on some very interesting projects in 2020. So for us, notwithstanding the difficulties and challenges that we've all faced, and some more than others, we've been working hard, focused. It's taken our minds off some of the wider societal difficulties and also enabled us to build in what we think is an incredible business.
So what shape are you in now? Give us a bit more detail.
Well, from lots of different perspectives, we're in great shape going into the year end. We're an operating exploration business, and that means that for us to be successful, we have to be operating on the ground, and we are across many of our projects. We are currently involved in drilling, or we've recently completed drilling on 3 of our projects, which is a major step for a junior resource company to have 3 projects actually doing drilling operations. We're also active across multiple of our interests, with soil sampling, with various reconnaissance reviews, with all sorts of different exploration techniques. And what we're trying to do is undertake as much activity as we can, as our resources will allow and our managerial kind of capabilities and time will allow, because we think that across our project interests with exploration, we stand the chance of making that major metal discovery. We may have made it already. If you've been reading the Molopo Farms updates, we've already drilled 1,000 meters of core drilling, diamond core drilling, and we will be moving to assay testing. So until we know for sure, we're going to keep on going.
So a number of potential value drivers here, you reckon, say, looking ahead the next 3 months, early into 2021?
I think so, yeah. We are kind of racking them up because we're in the high-risk game. So as much as I might be optimistic about a number of our projects at any time, you never really know. So having more things going is better. We have a double angle because alongside the exploration, we have the corporate work that we're doing. And people may be aware of that with the announcements we've made for the Australia Gold JV and also the Kavango Resources JV in Botswana. And there are other areas of our business that may lend themselves to corporate activity in the weeks and months ahead. So I think across our business, there stands a very good chance for our shareholders to see one of those announcements that makes life different for them. And that's my focus every day of the week.
Well, just to add to what you're saying there, Paul, these discussions around potential partnering for your projects in the likes of Australia, Botswana, Tanzania, these are continuing, these are ongoing, are they?
Well, that's a good question. And that's something I have to be careful in answering. Okay, we've made announcements with regard to our interest at the Molopo Farms Complex project in Botswana, the Haneti polymetallic project in Tanzania, that there have been various parties interested in what's being undertaken. Now, that's absolutely true. And that remains the case today because we're looking for large-scale nickel sulfide PGM targets in both of those projects. And those types of projects are difficult to come by. You don't get too many opportunities. So, of course, large firms who are scouring the planet for good nickel sulfide opportunities will always have you on radar. And it's the same for some of our other interests, notably the Australia Gold JV, where the Victoria Goldfields is hugely in focus around the world, and particularly from a North American perspective. And it's obvious that, you know, with such a large scale package of ground that we have under application in Victoria, there will be a lot of interest. Now, the question is how you take these things forward, because if you engage with partners too early, before you've really built value in any one project, then you might get a deal now. You might get something that causes the share price to rise rather dramatically now. But where's the longevity? If we're focused as we are on building a mid-tier scale business, then we need to be very careful that which partners we bring in, when we bring them in, and how we engage with those partners. We want partners who come in at fair value. We want to bring them in at the right time when we built proper value, and we want to bring them in on terms that will protect our shareholders and make sure that work is done expeditiously to build the value of the project or projects even more. So, yeah, there are lots of different levels of interest in what we're doing. Really, at the moment, we're focused on pushing our business forward aggressively. In my experience, that's the way you get the best engagement with third parties, when you just look like and behave like you're absolutely focused on driving the company forward organically without too much concern about who might be looking.
And from your experience, when has proper value been built? Is that when the discovery's been made?
I think so, in some cases. If you're dealing with a very large-scale base metal project, I think the large firms like to see some exploration undertaken. They don't like to take on dramatic risk. They want to see some core. It's always good to get some core out of the ground that they can inspect and they can apply their technical geological know-how to. Sometimes, if you look at some of the deals that have been done on the Australian Victoria Goldfields type projects, you can see quite dramatic valuations coming in at quite early stage because there is such a demand and interest and there's finance at project level for that kind of opportunity. So it varies dramatically. Our job is to steward our company very carefully, to manage and preserve its finances, to make sure we can continue to do work at all times, maintain that churn, as it were, of operational developments, until we find something of great substance. And then along the way, and possibly on discovery, manage the business so that we can engage with the right partners to take projects forward if that's appropriate. You know, at the end of the day, I'm paid to take care of shareholders' money. You know, when they invest in my company through financings or they invest through on market, then I have a duty of responsibility. So we're very serious about that. We're serious about building a very substantial business, and we're working literally almost night and day. Well, we're almost 24/7 now. We could open up a local store.
Continuing that operational development takes cash, of course. What state are your own finances in, or Power Metals finances in?
Yeah, well, it's a funny thing because I see so many of my beloved peers on the market who shroud their cash balance in mystery and they don't want to tell the market where they are, which I understand, because actually if the market finds out you have some finance challenges, it really goes for you. We publish our data on a regular basis, and we tell people where we are. And there's a couple of reasons for that. One is because we're in a strong position. And secondly, because it's important to be able to demonstrate that all this work that's going on, which does consume cash, is fully backed by the balance sheet of the business. And it's something we'd like to build even more. We want to build organically financial self-sufficiency so that we can fund our own operations internally and are not dependent on the market for these financings. So we're in a good place, and we look at this all the time. On my computer, I have open all the time the current position of the business. It's access to working capital. We have US dollar accounts, Australian dollar accounts, Canadian dollar accounts. We have money in various places. We invest in our projects properly, so we give our partners proper support. We're either on track with our payments or ahead of our payments on our programs. We have no debt, and we're entirely comfortable. One area that gives us some comfort is the fact that we have warrant money flowing into the business. And every time you see that money come in, then as a shareholder, it provides this business with the fuel it needs to carry on with accelerated growth of its operations. We also have a balance sheet that comprises various investments and interests. And some of those, we can create value, we believe, considerable value in the coming months. So that will provide us with further working capital. So yeah, on the finance side, I'm a chartered accountant, as you know. So it's a real source of focus for me. And I feel more comfortable now than I ever have with any public company I've been involved with.
Right. So what's the message, Paul, for 2021? What's the year about?
Well, we have a policy in our business towards communicating what we're doing. We talk about our programs when they start, when they're progressing, when they end, what we're doing, what our plans are for the business and its individual projects and interests. And we tell people exactly what's going on. So I want the message to be that our shareholders, if we perform and if we deliver, who hold this stock going forward, and I hope see a dramatic share price appreciation, can look back on the announcements that we released in 2020, can see the way that we've built and structured this business and how we've delivered the performance operationally with proactive exploration. And then can look back and say, yes, I saw the signs of a business that was growing, perhaps exploding value opportunities all over the place. I bought the stock, I held the shares, and I've seen a dramatic increase in my personal portfolio value because of Power Metal. And if that message comes to pass, as it were, over 2021, I will be delighted. We are in prime position to deliver on that objective. We have to have a little bit of good fortune along the way, not entirely, because some of this stuff is corporate and not just down to pure exploration, but a little bit of luck, constant hard work, proper delivery, proper communications, I think we can do something quite special.
An exposure to, or potential exposure to, one of the big metals, one of the big commodities of the future, nickel, of course.
Well, we have exposure to nickel, to PGMs, to gold, to silver, to copper, a whole range of rare earths. I could forget some of them if I'm not careful. At the end of the day, if I was a single project business or I had one or two projects, then I'd be very focused on whatever that project was, related to commodity-wise. But I'm spread across base and precious and strategic metals. I'm spread across the world. I have to keep all of our projects running because by doing that, we reduce the difficulty in finding those major discoveries.
Very good, Paul. Appreciate your time. We'll catch up in the new year. Thanks very much.
Great. Thank you very much. Happy New Year.